I already visited my rented room. We are gonna go to is that where the quest is? Didn't I have a quest somewhere here? I think I'm going crazy. Can you show me where the quests are? Oh no, we have to go to Narian. Wing. I wish it would show quest objectives. Star station. Ooh, it's Dipala though. We need to go there for something. Smai, Androphon, Magrath, Iperia, Nera, Crete, Victira, Ancelon. None of this is ringing any bells. Well, Dipala is something I know we have to do, so. Can we set course for there? Jump! Don't know which quest it was, but slow down there, slugger.
It's a great day the in the clinic. Space plant, huh?
That's what we need to do, the clinic. Surgical strike. Go to the clinic. Blake suggested I talk to Ranger Ben Armistead. Okay, so we need to do that, but we also need to do the supply relief run. Let's go. Oh, it's a long way away. We got real close there. Real close. Oh my god. I was like, oh god, oh god. Those numbers are going down. They're going down. All aboard. Should I be hailing things before I just dog?
I have never required to be rude here, and I hope that I never do.
I hope so too. Talk to Ben Armistead. Can I actually get the supplies first? That seems like the quicker thing. Where's Abby?
Ma'am, I'm just the courier.
I understand that. I'm not blaming you directly.
Lara.
Dr. Salvato, how long have you been here?
About a year now, Doctor.
And in that year, how many times have we had this conversation about late or missing shipments of supplies?
I believe this is the third time.
Yes, that sounds right. Three times. I will be making it very clear to your superiors that lives are at stake. And the clinic requires reliable transport. If your company cannot meet our needs, someone else will.
Yes, ma'am. Understood.
Thank you, Dr. Salvato. You may return to your duties.
He was required just for that? Okay. Lara?
Welcome to the clinic.
Thank you.
I'm Dr. Darvish, Chief of Medicine. Is there something I can do for you?
This is a medical facility?
I thought perhaps the name gave it away. This is one of the preeminent medical care centers in the Settle systems. We take our work very seriously.
I'm just looking around.
This is hardly the sort of place one comes to sightsee.
Uh-huh.
We have a particular focus on astrovirology here. So the patients we take on tend to have unusual cases that require long-term care. And sometimes require unorthodox or experimental treatments. We have an excellent track record that speaks for itself, but it doesn't leave room for much else.
Well, it shouldn't need to leave room for anything else.
Now,
you do what you need to do.
I will not insist that you leave, but if you are intent on looking around, as you put it, please don't interfere with our work and keep your distance from our patients.
Aye, ma'am. You mentioned astrovirology. What is that?
There are hundreds, if not thousands, of new worlds that humanity has set foot on. While many don't host some sort of life, there are more than enough that do. Any one of those worlds could be inhabited by all manner of pathogens, Things we've never seen and have no idea how to treat.
Space virology. I follow.
Someone has to try and stay ahead of what could be a very deadly curve. Here at the clinic, we do our best.
I hope you're paid well for what you do.
And none of us are in this for the credits. We are on the absolute edge of modern medicine, and we are dedicated to helping people no one else can. Either of those is reason enough for any of us to be here and do what we do.
Good for you. I like to help with your research.
Would you now? Well, I suppose we could always use additional research.
Yeah,
specimens.
I've sold all my resources, honey. I've got nothing left.
The more data we have about what's out there in the settled systems, the faster we can diagnose novel illnesses. In theory, at least. I suppose we could consider you an independent contractor of sorts.
So what do you specifically look for?
Organic membranes provide excellent data for treating viruses. We could use some additional samples.
I don't think I have any of those. 7? Jesus. Where do I find the resources you need?
What we're looking for are basic organic substances. They could come from any number of flora or fauna on countless worlds across the settled systems. Just keep your eyes open as you travel and harvest things when you find them.
I did that and my cargo got full.
Or frankly, if you can find them at a reasonable price somewhere, purchase them. I'm less concerned with the source than the materials themselves.
Okay, well, thanks.
Goes basic.
Thanks. Abby?
Need something? Dr. Cartwright in Aquila City said I was crazy when I told her I wanted to transfer here. Now I kind of understand why.
You're new here?
New-ish. I've only been here a year, which, well, when you compare it against Dr. Darvish's career, it's not much, is it? I'm thrilled to have the opportunity, but it's been an adjustment. Very few cases here are simple, and most of them are medical emergencies.
It must suck that, yeah, you don't get a break, you don't get to just, you know, unwind by going for a stroll in a park or look up at the sky.
I guess that depends on what you consider a break. We get some time to ourselves. We're not on call all the time, but we're never that far away from it either. Now that I think about it, I haven't actually left the clinic since I got the job.
That's real sad.
I actually hadn't really noticed.
That's real bad. Don't you want to go back to, you know? Aquila, say hi to Ms. Cartwright. I don't remember her first name. I couldn't stand being cooped up in one place for that long. That kind of routine can be comforting. Do you ever get homesick?
No, not really. This is my home now. The people here are wonderful, and the work we're doing is incredibly important. That's what really matters.
Joseph Manning sent me to pick up some medical supplies.
Hey, let's keep our voices down. The clinic doesn't exactly know I'm giving its supplies
I'm
away.
I'm sorry.
That being said, I've been expecting someone soon. I've heard Bayou really has a vice grip on Neon
right
now.
He's a bit
right
of
now.
A dick. I hope I get
I
to
have
kill
some
him
supplies
sometime.
I can give you. Should be more than enough for now, and it shouldn't draw any suspicion from the clinic. I'll have them loaded onto your ship.
Thanks, Abby. A few extra supplies couldn't hurt. What are you doing? Why are you doing this for Joseph Manning?
He's a good friend of mine. We both worked at the same clinic in Aquila City. The work was hard, and I was really young and nervous. But he always looked after me during those days and helped me as much as he could. So, to answer your question, I'm doing this because I know for a fact he'd do the same for me. No questions asked.
What happens if the clinic finds out about this?
What the clinic doesn't know won't hurt them. That's why it's important to keep this as confidential as possible. I'm putting my job on the line to do this, but I know that the people of Neon need help. I'm willing to take the risk and skim a few supplies from the clinic. But if the clinic finds out, then I'm out of a job and Neon is out of supplies. Again. So, let's not be too conspicuous.
I agree, which is why I'm not going to persuade you, because that will get you to lose your job. Thanks for your help.
Of course. The people of Neon aren't going to heal themselves.
No, they're only going to go
You'll
downhill because of Aurora.
You'll find the supplies on your ship. Hurry along before anyone suspects anything.
Hurry along, honey. I've got bigger things to do here. Oh my god, there are tarts here. What about my other quest? Talk to Ben. Ben! Ben. This way. Just don't do anything untoward.
You hear this from me? Those ecliptic mercenaries.
Yeah, I hear that on every single planet I go to. Hi.
Yeah? Got some trouble?
Yes.
Ooh, now hold on a minute. You're the new deputy, ain't you?
That's me, Ben.
The marshal's been sending out reports, keeping us all in the loop in your investigation.
Great, that'll save us both some time. Then you know I'm tracking down the members of the first. Good, because I don't want to waste your time explaining it to you. What does he say about me? Nope, you know what? I don't want to hear it.
Yep, I'm pretty well caught up on things. Ben Armistead, pleased to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you too, sir.
Guess that's the long and short of it. You're the newest member of the Rangers, and I'm the oldest.
Hey!
So, is one of them first mercenaries here at the clinic?
She had some kind of urgent medical issue, so I'm confident she's here.
Well, every Ranger knows it's important to trust your instincts. No better place in the settled systems to get medical treatment.
But aren't they entitled to privacy here?
You can bet it beats anything them UC piglets got.
Hey.
Ironic, given they're the ones who built it. I know just the man who can help you. Right this way.
But again, aren't they entitled to privacy? Sir, I can only follow you if you move.
Just between you and me, I ain't entirely sure why someone felt the need to station a ranger out.
I was thinking the exact same thing.
I'm not much more than a glorified bodyguard for Dr. Dark.
Oop, sorry, I meant to hit that. Not for God's sake, my fingernail hit tab.
She's the one in charge. And she's also on the Council of Governors.
Wait, she what?
Most of the staff don't seem fond of the idea.
That's news to me.
And I ain't fond of them.
It's the first I've heard of that.
Bunch of stuffy eggheads, if you ask me. Except Ari, that is.
Are you Ari?
The only one I can have a conversation with.
A couple of years on duty here, and anyone
hey there,
would be
Ari?
Qualified to
work in
another hospital
hardly
in
working.
The settled systems.
Hey, Chief. A little more of the former than the latter. What brings you by?
Well, the deputy here could use some help. Came looking for someone who might be a patient.
I'll see what I can
sure
do.
Those samples get disposed
well, I'll
of.
Leave you in Mr. Miller's capable hands.
You need,
anything else,
just
I'll be in my office.
One of the docs will get you right as rain in no
time. Oh, hush you, whoever you are. Pipe the fuck down. Hi, Ari.
I'll try to help you, but our computer systems have been having some issues.
Of course they have. That sounds about right.
The patient records database is acting up. Access is a lot slower than normal, and I have no idea why.
Because someone's hacking your system.
For now, let's focus on your investigation.
No. I think that there's something wrong because she's a computer expert.
Huh. Well, we don't give the patients free access to our computer system, so I doubt that's
right. Doesn't mean she can't hack into
it. Still, it's worth keeping in mind. So who's the suspect you're after?
A former soldier named Maya Cruz. She fought bravely in a colony war. A ruthless mercenary named Maya Cruz. I'm here to make sure she faces justice. I give no context.
The name's not ringing any bells, but maybe we can approach this another way. Do you know what was wrong with her?
It was a medical emergency that required long-term care, which is every single patient up here. I know it required a hospital stay. It sounded pretty urgent. Who cares? She's a criminal. She always deserves one way or another. Her name isn't enough.
That should help narrow things down.
It's like everybody here.
I can access the patient records from my terminal, assuming the database cooperates. Come on.
I have a feeling she's not even going to be in the database. Hold on. Caps off. Okay. Because you're having issues and she's the reason you're having issues.
Okay. Give me just a minute here.
I'm waiting for you to take a goddamn seat, Ari.
Maya Cruz. Maya Cruz. Come on, Maya. I need you to be in
here. She wouldn't be here under her own name,
though. Okay,
though.
Finally. Here we go. Oh. No matches found for a Maya Cruz.
Is there an MC of some kind?
If Maya's here, then she's got to be using an alias.
Could have told you that.
Which actually makes a lot of sense if she's a wanted woman.
You think? There must be someone who fits the description at least partially. What if the records were tampered with?
I guess it's possible. Maybe I can give you another option. All right, hang on. I know that we do have a few female patients staying with us. There's Candace... what's her last name? Doolin. Candace Doolin.
You're just giving me patient information.
And then there's the Nakamori woman.
I guess HIPAA doesn't belong here.
I don't recall offhand what they're here for, but it's a start.
Those are the only two you can remember. I'll talk to the patients.
Sorry I couldn't be more helpful. I'll keep looking, see if I can turn up anything else useful.
Just don't get yourself killed, Ari. Talk to Jane Nakamori. Talk to Candace Doolin.
I don't mean to be rude, but unless this is a medical emergency, please get someone else to help.
Perhaps we should consider not staying long. Or breathing deeply.
Please leave. Excuse me. What gives you the right to come in here? You're not my attending physician. Get out before I call for security.
That's very suspicious behavior right there. I'm very sorry to disturb you. I need a moment of your time. You seem tense. You hiding something?
Well, I suppose I can give you a minute.
I'm just gathering some information. What brought you to the clinic?
Believe me, I hadn't intended to stay here. I'm a courier. I was transporting certain sensitive documents here to the clinic. My ship was intercepted by pirates. I escaped, but not without damage to my life support systems. By the time I reached the clinic, I was barely alive. I was rescued and placed in intensive care. That was 2 days ago.
I think there's more to your story.
Well, the nature of my work requires a certain level of discretion. Much as yours does.
I agree with that.
I've shared all that I'm willing to share with you, Deputy.
Okay. I'm sure we can work something out. I promise it's just between us. I got a narrow window here, okay? Time's wasting.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I know you have your reasons. I'm just trying to help.
Look, I'd like to help, but...
just tell me and I'll get out of your hair.
I bet I'm more stubborn than you
are. Yes, you are.
I can see that you still have doubts.
Yeah.
If you don't believe me, then ask Mr. Miller at the desk. He can verify who I am and how I came to be.
He didn't even remember you. Literally didn't remember you, and you want him to verify? Verify? Hello? Against what?
Just 1 week.
The fake records? Candace Doolin?
This place makes me feel awful cooped up. Oh. I miss having my hands in the soil. Why, hello. Are you here to keep me company? I do hope so. I can't get any of these doctors or nurses to slow down and just check for a while.
Okay, I don't think it's
they
Candace.
They all claim they're too busy.
How terribly inconsiderate of them.
It certainly is. Why, I might as well be back home with my husband. He's just as bad. Oh, too busy to talk. That man couldn't sit still and listen if his life...
maybe you shouldn't have married him.
You'd think he could be bothered to pay me a visit once in a while, given I've been here as long as I have.
How long have you been here for?
But no. All I get is the occasional letter apologizing because he's too busy to run the farm all by himself. So hire some help, I tell him. And then all he wants to do is complain about how my medical bills ate up all our money. Ugh. Truly, this is riveting.
Oh, the deadpan tone. Oh. I need to ask you some questions.
You want to talk about questions, uh-huh. Well, I've got plenty of those. Starting with how come these so-called doctors can't find anything wrong with me?
Then why are you here?
I've got no end of pains. Headaches, sore knees, sore back, digestive problems.
Well, half of that's probably because you work on a farm. Physical labor's beyond you at your age.
I must have caught some kind of alien virus. But these fool doctors can't figure it out. I'd had test after test for 3 months straight, and I'm damn near broke from the cost of staying here.
You're not my suspect. You're a hypochondriac.
Well, ain't you smart, using them big words? If that's supposed to make me feel better, I got news for you. It don't.
It's not meant to make you feel better.
I thought the high and mighty Free Star Rangers was supposed to help others
in
need.
I'm not paying for your medical attention.
Mate, I think that sterling reputation's getting a little tarnished lately.
Well, guess what happens when you run out of money, honey?
Go on, then. Don't let the troubles of one poor citizen distract you from whatever higher calling you all answer to these days.
Well, yeah, there are more important things, love, than you. I don't have any footsteps. Rupshit Creek without a paddle.
Hey, how'd it go? Do you have any luck?
Definitely not Candace. I'm hoping you've got some new information, bro.
As a matter of fact, I do. I made some progress digging through the patient records, and I have one more lead for you. Her name's Catalina Rivera. She was rushed into surgery for some kind of emergency procedure. I probably shouldn't say this, but she was in real bad shape. The good news is, she seems to fit your suspect's profile. The bad news is that she's a guest in our VIP wing.
How much did you have to pay to get there?
That area is restricted to authorized clinic personnel. Even I can't go in there.
Okay. What can you tell me with the VIP wing?
Think of it as high-end care, with bigger rooms, better food, and more amenities. Cost a fortune, of course. The VIP wing also provides privacy. And that's why only a select few staff members are allowed in.
Okay, I thought Rangers could go anywhere in Freestyle space.
Yeah, well, I don't think the doctors here care all that much about where the Rangers are supposed to go. Dr. Cassidy's in charge of the VIP wing. You need his permission to enter.
Cassidy.
Unfortunately, he's a real stickler for the rules, and the rules say no visitors without prior arrangement.
We could fake prior arrangement.
You didn't hear this from me. But I happen to know that he keeps a spare access card somewhere in his office. Hope that helps you.
I think your big turret guns are gonna see me. Ugh. Okay. Well, that's him. Hi, sir. Can I try you first? And if it doesn't work?
Yes. What do you want?
I'm gonna steal your card. I could really use your help. I need to talk to someone in the VIP wing. It's a good bet you've got a fugitive hiding in your VIP wing. I need access. I need to get into the VIP wing. Don't ask why it's confidential. You're the one in charge of the VIP wing?
I'm sorry, but we don't permit unscheduled visitors to that area. You'll need to ask whoever it is that you wish to visit to make arrangements with me. Who exactly are you?
How am I supposed to get them to arrange it if I can't talk to them because they're behind the VIP wing door? Deputy Dusty, at your service. I really need your help. I require your cooperation with an investigation.
And I require you to respect my authority as a senior doctor here at the clinic.
Yeah, I thought that's as well as
the
it would go.
The answer is no.
Okay.
The rules are the rules. No exceptions.
Watch me get around your rule.
Flexibility clearly is not one of his virtues.
Nope. Medicine. I give you my word as a fellow medical professional that I'll be very discreet.
Oh, I wasn't aware. I suppose if I can't trust a colleague, then I can't trust anyone. This will get you in.
Yes.
Conduct your investigation quickly and without disruption.
Got it.
I do hope you won't make me regret this.
I'm so glad that two of my backgrounds now have been super useful. The Neon Street Rat and this.
Mind your step.
God, you may as well say mind the gap while you're at it. Where the fudge am I going? He clearly wasn't coming from the VIP wing. This is the VIP wing. I read the walls, it would totally tell me that. Hello? Yeah, I'm in the VIP wing. Talk to Catalina Rivera. Well, I'd like it if you could tell me where the bloody hell she was. You only have one room?
I have never ripped pipe.
No.
Did you hear that?
Yeah!
Meet your death!
Hacked. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. You ain't... She got her brains blown out. Oh, sweet dear God. Well, since we're here, is there anything we want to loot? Medical supplies? Anywhere? Yes. Oh, it's considered stealing. Why is it still said to go back there? I don't get it. Come on, Andreja. Check every room. Leave no room unchecked. Shame I can't loot. Is there a ship at the dock? Ooh, where is she? Is she in a docked ship? Clear. Search for clues. Yo! Oh my fucking god! We good? Okay. Well, does that count as a clue? What are we looking at for clues, by the way? What do you consider a clue? I'm so confused. Well, the modified terminal would be a good place to start. Command override mode. Access mainframe. Install disruptor. MKIV run disruptor. Executing operation successful. All other admin functions suspended. Disable program. Patient terminal. Terminal access logs. MMO mode. Please select a task. Reveal a guest. Establish a link. Set navigation. Sakharov. Execute automated pre-flight procedures because she's too injured to drive to fly. Okay, well that tells me where she's going. Treatment continues, but issues persist. Prognosis is not optimistic. Patient seems unusually anxious since receiving a recent courier slate. Possibly some bad news from home. Cool. Well, that's a clue. Is it not? Well, I think it's a clue. Marker, screwdriver. Or do I have access to the slate that she read? That'd be pretty useful. Unfortunately, this place has been blown to kingdom come. I don't really know what I'm looking for. Is that a slate? Urgent, read immediately. Maya, the Rangers are on to us. They're going to find you, and when they do, an alliance won't protect you. The best bet is to hunker down somewhere safe. Your hideout in the old asteroid mine at Sakharov should be ideal. Maybe still want to collect emergency ships if you need a quick escape. I know you don't have much time. The operation's almost over. Thanks for helping see it through. And if I don't get the chance to tell you in person, I'm eternally grateful for your brave service and loyalty to the unit. It's been an honor. Major Hurst. Are we going to talk to... anybody and go, hey, there's a dead doctor back here? No? Hey, Art. You've got a corpse back there.
Every new alien pathogen we discover is just a little more job security.
Anybody?
On the bright side, right?
What do you call them?
Does anybody corns? Care about the body?
Yeah. I got corns.
Art.
Don't let anyone know.
Always happy to help the Free Star Rangers. All right, see you around.
Sir Cassidy?
I'm sure there's someone else that can help. If you need assistance, please see Ari Miller at the desk.
Okay, well, if no one gives two shits about the dead doctor, I guess I'll just be leaving.
I'm probably fine. Yeah, I'm fine.
Thanks for delivering. It's a grav drive. I literally can't get here any faster.
Maybe you need a better grav drive. I hit E.
Any adventure you can fly away from. Is that how the saying goes?
It is. Smeon, let me through! So where is Sakharov? Oh god. Oh god. Okay. Where's Red Mile? Back at Parma. Yep, gotcha. Okay, so the past, it's where we're heading. First contact. You are back in Parma. That's back at Neon. Don't care. How am I gonna get rid of that bullshit? Return to Joseph. Back at Neon. Actually, where were you? Back at Parma. God damn it, everything's Parma. Or we go to the Sol system. The wolf one is still there. finish that one? It seems kind of important. And I also want to just get rid of that quest because it's been sitting there for ages. I don't mind waiting for Sidonia until I get the book. That's fine. Okay, so Podimir is clearly the next plan of attack, so let's just head back to the UC Vigilance in the Sol system. If there's anything else we need to do in Nardion, I don't remember what it is.